Now that we have discussed a few foundational aspects of software architectures, and we have looked at some real-world examples that help us to illustrate some of these points, to discuss some of these aspects, I want to introduce and define the different elements that compose a software architecture and also talk about architectural styles. So let's start by discussing a software architecture's elements. A software systems architecture typically is not and should not be a uniform monolith. On the contrary, an architecture should be a composition and interplay of different elements. In particular, as we quickly mentioned at the beginning of the lesson, there are three main types of elements in an architecture: processing elements, data elements, and interaction elements. Processing elements are those elements that implement the business logic and perform transformations on data. Data elements, also called information or state, are those elements that contain the information that is used and transformed by the processing elements. And finally, the interaction elements are the glue that holds the different pieces of the architecture together. Now, the processing elements and the data are contained into the system components, whereas the interaction elements are maintained and controlled by the system connectors. And components and connectors get all cooked together into a systems configuration, which models components, connectors, and their relationships. So now let's look at components, connectors, and configurations in a little more detail.